John's interested in immersive audio. How to set up a multi-channel monitoring system? Actually, it's quite easy. For me, I would say the first and foremost format to go to is Dolby, and they make it really easy for you. And once you've figured out how to make it work with Dolby, then you can look at other immersive formats like Sony 360 or Auro 3D and those kind of things. But Dolby do a good job with their instructions and all their documentation and the support structure that's around that. And I would say start there. And the place you start first is called the DART, the Dolby Atmos Room Design Tool. And it's an Excel spreadsheet, and you put the dimensions of your room in there. You can move the locations of the loudspeakers around. You can select different loudspeakers. You can change the SPL that you want to monitor at. And Dolby will tell you whether you're within the guidelines or not. And from there, it's quite simple, really. Just build it. Should I work in immersive and then mix down to stereo, or the other way around? The way I would approach it, I would start in immersive and then mix down. The immersive audio offers you more space to mix into. And then that the way that translates across the devices now is becoming much more seamless. Again, immersive audio is available on most people's phones these days. Most headphones and playback systems have a head-related transfer function built in so that they give a reasonable approximation of immersive audio over headphones. So you don't need to have a fancy room. But I would probably work in tandem, spend a bit of time in the immersive and then do it in stereo. And maybe you find something when you go into stereo that you go back and you want to rejig in your immersive mix. And never be afraid to go back and change stuff. You know, everything's a learning process, but that's how I would do it.